The water along Caviar Key is frequently described as gin clear. Which reminds me, I could go for another Singapore Sling. Port Clovis City Council never misses an opportunity for cross-franchise. The spectacle of a rampaging shark never fails to attract us.
Reports out by Caviar Key. Find it and put it down.
Planet's great tides encircle the globe in constant motion.
Oh,
probably have four motives: hunger, mistaken identity, aggression, and self-defense. But what if there's a fifth motive, such as a life insurance scheme? The ocean, a fluid and fascinating world, always changing, forever in motion. Coastal overdevelopment creates a riskier, more complex local environment. The idea that shorelines belong to the public comes from Roman Emperor Justinian, but only because he wasn't able to consult with the Association of Resort Developers of Eternally Wise Lobbyists. It's vital that we extract an absolute maximum of resources before we cross Earth's apocalyptic threshold. Yes, it's quite beautiful here. Unfortunately, bull sharks can't see color. Stream brings warm waters northeast across the Atlantic towards English seaside towns filled with cranky pensioners, donkey rides, and heroin addicts.
Eyes peeled, everyone. Is that it?
Humans have seen less than 5% of our oceans, which means there's still plenty of treasure out there for everybody. Catastrophic risks for future generations, but then we couldn't have 4x4 pickups with 5.7-liter V8 engines. Humans' attention spans are short. They've already forgotten about the shark and her many crimes, so thus ends the bounty. As we face impending resource scarcity and declining living standards, it's nice to know that in the meantime, there's still a place to get a good bamboo fusion massage. The accelerating destruction of the Gulf has occurred in tandem with a wholly humanized view of progress and development. Along Blanchard County's 78-mile coastline, there are 35 miles of sandy beach, only six of which aren't owned by resorts, individuals, or homeowners associations. The air out here has a distinctive smell, that of sea salt, nitrogen oxide, and an intriguing bouquet of volatile.
Got said Captain Blighty sunk his treasure somewhere around here. Been funding a diving expedition every year for 10 years and I ain't found it yet.
The powers of society have retaliated with deterrent action, but mankind is ultimately impotent to stop Mother Nature's vengeance.
Thank you.
To indulge in mindless, gratuitous.
Back when he was a teenager. This museum's the first place I took him after.
The rapacious rover is always swimming, searching for anything to satisfy the gluttony that is their defining trait. The battle is over, but the war goes on. Lacking sufficient sand or protective dunes, heavily developed areas risk great danger from hurricanes and tropical storms. Benjamin Franklin marveled at how quickly the Gulf Stream allowed him to travel back to America after his many Parisian horny expeditions. The shark hunting sector has experienced significant growth, leaving a lot of local openings for amusement ride operators.
The university sends their students out here every summer to study the reefs. Shit. Guess we all got different ideas about summer fun, yeah?
Thank you.
another unsuccessful shark hunt for the people of Port Clovis. Ton of food every day, which here in the Gulf mostly consists of hammerhead sharks. Scavengers of the sea are vital in cleaning the ocean floors of edible and semi-edible detritus. Staircases and a mosaic swimming pool, the Chatelaine is still only Port Clovis's second most ostentatious yacht.
Watch out, shark, huh?
anybody see her. Should have brought my fish finder. She gotta be somewhere out here. Come on now. The hell is it? I just know she's near. Wrap it up for now, boys.
Port Clovis has grown bored of the hunt, leaving our shark to fight another day.
Challenge.
alienness of the shark is its lack of a skeleton. Forgotten all about its rogue shark, for now.
We'll be right back.
cetacean assassin, the sperm whale. Practically ran on sperm whale oil. Now we can only watch them from afar, dreaming skulls for all that sweet spermaceti.
Shark hunters have arrived. Soon we will.
will see them in action and quite possibly discover which one of them stole my car steering wheel.
Cryptosporidiosis, leptospirosis. Let me tell you, partner, that ain't no joke.
System comes alive with amplified vibrations.
Thank you.
Pete has a new boat, and from the looks of it, there are several features probably not legal for civilian use.
So you found me. So what?
Pete, I don't know what all this is, but you're scaring us.
What you gotta be scared about? You a shark?
Pete, I don't want to, but I think we need to get the police, maybe the Coast Guard involved?
You think I'm crazy? No, I'm the most sane man you ever seen. Look, I didn't get it easy. But when some shark take everything I got, I give her the same chance she gave my boy. None! Now get the f*** off my boat, or I'll kill you too. The f*** I say! Hope you got a hunger on! We serving shark étouffée tonight!
Pete has built an impressive battleship, but will it be enough to endure the prehistoric might of a mega shark? Once more, the shark turns back to this place of centered calm.
Hello there, girlie. As you can see, I came prepared today. I'm a bitch for real, bro. Better watch how you pushing my luck. Laissez les bons temps rouler.
I suppose there's a lesson to be gleaned here. Something about how the increasing commodification of the natural world has placed humans on a collision course with an environmental apocalypse. But this is a basic cable show where people tune in to watch sharks kill people and people kill sharks. So until next fishing season, this is Maneater. The peace of the grotto enables the shark to approach the world with greater confidence and effectiveness. As the terrain of the Gulf Coast is relatively flat, even a small rise in sea levels could trigger an immense loss of land. Local resorts have responded to sea level rise by importing 285,000 tons of sand and counting. Coastal erosion currently impacts over 70% of the globe's sandy beach environments. Prosperity Sands reminds us that sometimes the construction of second and third homes supersedes considerations like loss of species diversity. Parrotfish use their strong beaks to scrape plants and algae from coral reefs. Coastal tourism in the U.S. continues to grow, leaving millions of naive Americans vulnerable to the graft of beach umbrella renters. Scientists have hypothesized that sharks can mistake boats for a whale or some other large creature that doesn't really look at all like a boat. Shark hunters stalk their prey, fully aware of the grisly horrors that await them upon a sea visit. There would have been more wilderness surrounding Prosperity Sands were not the public already so dumb about ecological concerns in general.
Could be her.
Local fauna. Beach erosion can be harmful to ecosystems by changing habitat conditions for such local fauna as seals, sea turtles, birds, and fish. The water along Caviar Key is frequently described as gin clear. It reminds me, I could go for another Singapore swim. The hunt is over, and there will be an inevitable rush on dollar drafts at Flamingo Joe's. An impressive display of ruthless cunning and hideous strength from the shark. Thank you. To see this area is to witness the inability of the Hydrosphere to support the growth of humanized landscapes along the Gulf. An insatiable fish, the bull shark is 9/10 appetite. Given the number of people who frequent the beach, it can be rationally assumed that a little human urine finds its way to the sea. Coastal overdevelopment creates a riskier, more complex local environment. The seawolf remains acutely aware of anything that might constitute food. Thank you. day at the beach is a summer ritual that wouldn't be complete without plenty of sunshine, sandcastles, and Sercarial dermatitis.